Knowing the differences between screen size and screen resolution is an important part of building an app for mobile devices. Hi, I'm Ryan from Webiotic. Let's take a look at what these terms mean, what the differences are, and why it matters. First, let me start by saying screen size and screen resolution aren't the same thing and shouldn't be used interchangeably. It's crucial to have a good understanding of each of these terms when it comes to developing an app because they each have their own place in optimizing an app for various devices and screen sizes, like smartphones, tablets, smart TVs, and other screens. The screen size is simply the physical size and measurement of the screen, and screen resolution is the number of pixels on the screen. For example, an iPhone 12 has a 6.1-inch screen size and a screen resolution of 2532 by 1170 pixels at 460 ppi. Remember, devices with the same screen size can still have different resolutions. Let's take a quick look at some common terminology you'll find when referring to screen size and resolution. Pixels. Pixel, short for picture element, is the smallest individual element that makes up a display. It's the single color dot from which you can create a larger image. The number of pixels in an image is what determines the resolution. If you have a 10 by 10 pixel image, it means that the grid is 10 pixels wide and 10 pixels high, meaning you have a total of 100 pixels. Points. Points aren't the same thing as pixels. This is a unit of length, most often used to measure the height of a font. How many pixels equal a single point depends on the resolution of the given image. If you have an image that's 72 ppi, pixels per inch, then one pixel will equal one point. DPI. DPI is short for dots per inch and is also sometimes referred to as PPI, which is pixels per inch. DPI calculates the number of pixels in an inch of screen. Now, let's run through some basics for developing an app for iOS or Android screen compatibility. When developing an app, the screen size takes into account screens like the screen orientation, screen UI elements, like a navigation bar, and changes to the window configuration, like multi-window mode. By default, your app's layout will be resized to fit the screen it's being viewed on. To ensure it resizes well, app developers will need to implement a flexible app layout. For example, rather than hard coding the size and positioning of UI elements, it's better to allow view sizes to stretch, specifically their positions relative to the parent or sibling views, so the intended sizes remain the same as the layout changes. Regarding pixel density, the goal when developing your app is that it has density independence, which is when it has the ability to maintain the physical size the UI designed when shown on screens with varying pixel densities. This is important because without it, UI components like buttons, for example, might look too big on a low density screen or too small on a high density screen. iOS uses a coordinate system based on measurements in points, which translate to pixels in the display. A standard baseline resolution has 1x1 pixel density, with one pixel equating to one point. Since higher resolution displays have higher pixel density, they demand images with a greater number of pixels. As you can tell, there's a ton of details you'll need to know about and implement when creating an app for multiple devices and screen sizes. When in doubt, read the docs. Both iOS and Android come with thorough documentation on best practices and specifications for designing an app on multiple devices. I hope you learned something today about the differences between screen resolution and screen size. For more help with your app, subscribe to our channel. If you like this video, please like it and share it with others. Thank you for watching.